So, let's get this done and over with. My opinion on dark has always been skeptical. Dark has always used these victim cards, basically, to claim he has somehow lived a worse life than most people online. But I'm not gonna lie. I don't believe he has them. People over on dark side claim I'm the bully, I'm the bad guy, when they don't even take into consideration that what I do, is that I allow my audience to not only listen and read the evidence that I post up there, I allow them to go onto my DeviantArt account and look around. Hell, they can look around every part of my account and read every single comment I've ever posted or linked to or whatever. And I'll freely give them the notes that I've ever talked to Dark with and everything else. Yes, I'm even saying to other accounts, even Dark's, even though he's deactivated. You want to know why? Because I'm not afraid of them being the journalist as well. Because I know I have done nothing wrong. I have said nothing wrong. I have done nothing wrong in this entire ordeal. All I've done is just blocked Dark and asked him calmly, nicely, as best I can, time and again, to leave me alone. When I didn't get that, I allowed him a platform to ask him a few questions, and which he constantly pissed me off to the point that I decided to say, fuck it. Fuck it all. I'm just going to block him. He is so insufferable, incomprehensible, and illogical that it is impossible to even have a common, decent conversation with this man about. And I mean that. He constantly uses his emotions. He constantly never makes sense. He takes back what he says moments before, as if he doesn't want to ever take responsibility for what he says on the net. Worse off, he has gone above and beyond to attempt to ruin my life. And that is probably the worst thing of all. I'm not gonna lie when I say that personally I feel this whole entire vendetta / fiasco is, out of everything I've ever dealt with, entirely ludicrous. Because of one simple fact. This whole thing started because I blocked Dark. I blocked Dark over an argument where I had the last say. And Dark not only didn't take the time to calm down, he decided to make an absolute ass of himself on the internet where everyone could have front row seats to watching a man make an absolute idiot of himself, making threats and comments, even posting his personal information, expecting absolutely no repercussions for those actions whatsoever to happen when he did it. Never in my life did I even expect that this man would continue to act so irrational that he would continue to put me to blame for everything he did because of that one simple action that I know anybody in their sane, logical, sound mind, or even in their slightly illogical mind, like Scott, if they were blocked, would not throw as big a tantrum as this to go this far. With Dark, not only did he go so far that when he deactivated, he was still cursing me all the way offline. and yet still came online through a friend of his to continue to communicate with me. It boggles my mind that not only did he continue to cross a line that I said if he continued to contact me, I would post a rant video up, that he actually decides to give me full-on permission to post the rant. After I do, he decides it's not good enough or something of the like, and decides to report it in an attempt to get my YouTube channel banned along with my account on DA, because I also blocked his friend in an attempt to stop his friend from being a leeway for him to get in contact with me. Not only does he go this far, but when he does come back online to tell me off on a new account that I don't give a shit about, he continues to harass me to no ends, threatening me all the way around and shaming me for being the way I am, trying to tell me that I ought to stop because I have too many enemies, and the entire site of DeviantArt absolutely hates me because of reasons. Not only does he go this far, but when he does deactivate, he does it because he's now in the mental hospital because he gave a threat, actually making an attempt to now shame my friends into getting me to take down the evidence and video backing up my claims that yes, he's been the bully. Yes, I was the one who was innocent. Yes, I haven't done anything in the wrong to provoke this any further than it has. Yes. He's been the one causing all this, even though he gave this threat and it was failed moments after. Over a couple hours later, Dark literally makes an attempt in reality so severe that it lands him in the mental hospital. Not only that, but he actually puts me still to blame for him being in the mental hospital, because I did not take down the evidence that clearly showed he was the one who did all the things claimed. Not only this, but even while he's in the mental hospital, one of his friends makes an attempt to make peace that is a clear sign of absolute censorship. You want to know why? I know, because I didn't take the screenshot of the journal. The actual journal not only posts a like of the actual real life of Dark's story, which is absolute hypocrisy, but it also shows that when Dark comes back online, we are all to play the censorship game, meaning we're not allowed to talk about what Dark went through, so that Dark can feel like he's in a safe space. You know, treat him like a special SJW snowflake. That was the final nail in the coffin. Dark, despite all the shit he put me through, despite me constantly begging and asking to be left alone, well, that's the final nail. He is going to be given special treatment when he gets back online. While I, yes, I've had the attacks finally stop, the fact is, I've been left here just in the dust, realizing that man has been given every right and opportunity to still act like an absolute total man-child. He is being coddled and cuddled like a little infant because he couldn't get his way. Here I have been, using every logic and sound reason to actually defend my case as best as possible. And yes, I'm not going to lie. Dark did at one point attempt to ruin my online career by claiming I gave a death threat to a 13-year-old, even though I'll do a later rant to prove otherwise. And the truth is, I didn't, if you look at the evidence a little clearer. It boggles my mind just how fucking imbecilic all of this boils down to when you consider the start of this entire fiasco, the start of this entire thing, all boils down to just me blocking him. A perfectly normal thing that happens to millions of people online day after day, yet you know this situation doesn't happen to this extreme because we're all rational, sensible, thinking adults about the blocking system. The most logical reaction is a meh, I don't give a shit, or oh my gosh, my friend blocked me, I better go find out why. And other reasons, of course. But otherwise, we don't make a big ordeal out of it. The fact is, in my opinion, and yes, it's true, I find this whole fiasco absolutely, positively ridiculous. I cannot believe Dark went this far and trying to pose as me being the bully when all I've wanted and desired was to be left alone. As for his friends, I cannot believe they cannot respect that they want me to still get in contact with this man who legitimately made full-on attempt after full-on attempt to ruin my life. And in my opinion, somewhat succeeded. Now a number of deviant artists hate me and fully believe I wanted this man to commit what he committed to get into the mental hospital. My honest response? I am glad he is in the mental hospital. Because had he succeeded in whatever he attempted, I would indeed be 10 times more sad about what he went through. Because I would either have to live with the fact that he maybe did commit suicide, martyr, maybe kill someone. Who knows? But the fact is, I am glad he is in the mental hospital, someplace safe that could actually give him the genuine help he so desperately needs. Because then and only then can he finally get the psychological help he actually should get about many of the quote-unquote stigmas and victim cards he constantly uses online, such as online PTSD that he's self-diagnosed, and tail side of the coin, split personality, and many of the other mental diseases Dark has obviously given himself over his years because he didn't have the brain cells to actually talk to a therapist about it. I am not joking. He is clearly retarded because he actually posted his real life information, but for those who say I did take it too far in the rant video, let me inform you I actually had a backup information that I did not release. I did not post Dark's real life face along with his mother's, and yes, I do have the uncensored version of Dark's real life. So for those who think I took it too far, no, I didn't. I was a long ways from taking it too far. I didn't post Dark's personal information. I didn't post anything that was too far, in my opinion. Taking things too far would be like posting Dark's actual Facebook, his actual face, and yes, along with his mother's in that one image, along with a few other things that were actually in my back pocket. I know, I'm not going to get any thanks because of this. But I don't give a shit. I stick to my morality code, whether or not you imbeciles like it or not, and whether or not I get a thanks because of it, which I know I didn't. From Dark, he didn't once give me a single thanks for censoring his personal information. What an idiot. I mean, come on. How am I toying with his life? At least I know better than to post my personal information online, where millions of people can see it and clearly come find me in reality to try and perhaps murder me. At least I know better than to at least treat blocking like it's somehow breaking a friendship. Because then I can know for a fact whether or not it's a glitch in the system, like on YouTube and other sites, rather than something else. With Dark, he clearly overreacted. And overreacted to the point of acting like an absolute total troll bait. This has been Annie the Enigma, aka Nayu Simonova from DeviantArt. Thank you so much for watching. I am sorry for talking in this manner. The reason for this being, I've been doing this sort of video over and over and over and over this audio in specific. So, in a nutshell, after doing it for so long, I kind of needed a way to say it so that it just sounded generic. So you're gonna have to forgive the overall tone of it. This is so that I don't offend too many people, but also so that I could add a bit of humor in some shape and form. Also, my throat is hurting me. You're gonna have to forgive that, but after doing this for so long, whatever. Thank you so much for watching this. I don't give a shit if you leave a like or a dislike. I know this whole fiasco needs to be done and over with. So perhaps after this, there will be no more reasons for me to make any more. Thank you. Just gives me mad attention, like I'm under inspection.